we've increased revenue in the canal about six times as much as we did when we had it. They put in a very professional group of operators in charge of the canal, and that has helped a great deal. And in addition to that, the Panama Canal Zone that we use primarily as a military base, they've used it for commercialization and for improving the lives of all the Panamanians. So it's been a very good improvement, and, of course, they've been very ambitious about the future. I was down there when they began the expansion of the canal to accommodate much larger ships. So all in all, I've been very pleased at the political and economic progress that's been made in Panama and for the whole world, I would say, since the Panamanians took over control. Well, first of all, the original engineering was superb, and they still use a basic structure of the lock management and that sort of thing to get ships through in an expedited way. But I was there, and I joined in with General Torrijos' son, who was the president then, and he and I pushed the plunger together to start the first excavation in doubling the capacity of the canal. And since then, they've been pretty well on schedule. I think they're about a year behind, but the new canal will be open soon. And so I've been extremely pleased with what the Panamanians have done in utilizing the canal and making it available to more people and larger ships throughout the world. Well, I'm excited, I'm pleased, and I'm very grateful that the Panamanians have done such a superb job, not only in operating the canal, but also increasing its revenue, and at the same time expanding its capacity. So they've just exceeded my own very high expectations on how well they have taken care of the canal and used it properly. Was one of the high points. It was an example of the legitimacy and need for a very strong human rights policy, first of all. It showed that we had confidence in the Panamanian people and we were willing to treat them fairly. And I think strategically, it's been a very good boon to everybody in the world who utilizes the canal for commercial purposes. And it's promoted peace and stability in the entire region. Now, Panama GDP for the people, the average income for individual citizens in Panama has skyrocketed, primarily because they've managed the canal so well. So in every way, I'm very pleased and grateful for what's happened. Well, first of all, in the region, that is, in this hemisphere, every country soon became a democracy instead of a dictatorship in South America, because of our human rights policy. So that was a major change that took place. I'm very grateful for that. The Carter Center has now monitored more than 100 troubled elections in the world, and we began that process with what we learned in Panama, which was our first one. And so we went from there to Nicaragua and then to other countries in Latin America and now all over the world. Our most recent one was in Myanmar, formerly Burma. So Panama has been an example to me in many ways in promoting peace, human rights, and democracy in a small country, but we've expanded it to a worldwide commitment.